Everyone, welcome in. Okay, it's been a minute, but I am back. So listen, first up on the list is Angel Briggs. Okay, she posted this right here and it says, "It's my birthday, so thankful for family, love, success, and speaking of birth, it's almost time. More surprises on the way." So the Neighborhood Talk posted Angel Briggs and Rockstars, a little bundle of joy. It's almost here. So I was shocked, you guys. Yes, I was. And I was a little thrown off because I did not see these two as a couple. Not that I care because I don't follow them on social media, but I do know Angel Briggs from Love & Hip Hop as well as Rockstar from Love & Hip Hop, and he's a producer, okay? But not only is he a producer, I've known him for having the tea, okay? Having the drama, arguing all the time, the loudness, the shadiness, okay? I thought he was Tinkerbell, straight up. I did, okay? I did not know he was straight. And I would have never thought these two would have made a baby together. I just never seen them as a match, but congratulations. Now, let's move on to Hazel E, who says she is undergoing more surgery despite having a botched surgery experience in Turkey, where she lost her boobs, y'all. Do y'all remember this right here?
I would have left the boob in. I could have got even sicker. I wouldn't be around for Ava anymore. So, I had to have the mommy makeover.
Right. She went through a horrible, terrible experience, but yet she is willing to risk her life and go back under the knife. What do you all think about this?
I'm not going to Turkey. There's nothing wrong, but they really fucked me up in Turkey, so I feel like I have the right to go ahead and have a redo to fix that situation. You feel me? I just want to do it safely and, you know, I know you can't achieve perfection, but shit, baby, I'm gonna try. I'm always gonna try. It's gonna be light. It ain't no titties and nothing like that. So I'm not getting no plastic parts on the inside. We just gonna take out the things that they messed up.
I say, why put your life at risk, okay? It's your body, I know, but is it worth it, you know? Like, is it worth it? You already have your husband, your family, you know, is it stopping you from making money? Like, is it really worth it? I'm guessing when she looks in the mirror at night, she don't like what she sees. Regardless of what anybody says, I don't think she likes her body, you know, and it's her body. Maybe risking her life again is what's going to give her that boost of self-confidence, you know, boost her self-esteem. I don't know. I wouldn't do it. But like I said, that's her. And that's all I have to say on that. Now let's move on to Kanye West, okay? Who is out here walking around like a white man. Yes, dressed up looking like Michael Myers or a flat out killer. How come celebrities, you guys, how come they get away with all the foolery, being naked, exposing themselves and all that other stuff? Like, how come celebrities get away with the foolery of it all? Okay, imagine if everyone dressed like them, it dressed up like Kanye. Okay, there would be a lot of crimes going on, a lot of criminals getting away with robberies and things like that. Like, everybody can't dress like this, so how come they get to do it? Kim, come get your man. That's all I'm gonna say, girl. Come get your man. You are the only one who understands his bizarre behavior. Girl, what is wrong with him? What are y'all doing to him behind closed doors? I really want to know. And then when he takes off the mask, he is showing off his new haircut that is jacked all the way up. But I guess to him, it's art, it's trendy. This is why I said to myself a long time ago when I seen him trying to do this whole church thing, like, it was a fake, a phony, a fluke, okay? Him turning his life over to God, okay, was bullish. It was fake. He had all those minions following his God, okay? But I believe Kanye is doing all this off-the-wall stuff just for clout, to get the people talking, and he is doing a good job at it, all right? Meanwhile, Bobby Smurf, okay, how y'all say it, Schmurder? He is out here teaching the men how to wind up the hips, man. Look at this boy right here, y'all.
That's what I'm talking about, but I'm saying, you niggas need some WD-40 or some shit, bro. Like, I don't know, you motherfuckers too stiff. Like, you gotta be like, the girls are complaining, bro. You gotta wind out or she hold, bro. You gotta hit all angles. You can't just be in there, give. No, cause you gotta hit all angles, up, down, side, beep, beep, beep. She ain't gonna ever go back home, trust me. Now, I'm gonna get some lessons out like this for you fellas. Now.
Okay, so due to copyright issues, I did have to turn the music down, okay? But you already see where I'm posting it from. But, you know, I was checking him out. Okay, Bobby, he got a nice little body going on, nice little smooth, you know, one tone, okay? But, ladies, do you want your man moving like this in the bedroom, all hip side to side, dip, dip, wine and wine?
That's enough, Liz. I'm telling y'all, she ain't gonna ever come back home, girl. Holy, they back on my phone.
Is he drilling a hole or is he having sex? I don't know. I don't want my man all over the place like this, okay? Drilling a damn tunnel. Boy, keep it steady. Long, strong, hard, good motion, okay? Deep strokes, you know, not drilling in the damn new wall, okay? Are you having sex or are you trying to make a hole? It's good for dancing, but not during sex. I don't know. Okay, so people were saying jail changed him, but Bobby's been dancing like this. It's him. He was dancing like this on this video right here, okay? He went to prison before his career really got started, so people are really seeing who he is right now, okay? I tell you one thing, he is really gonna outshine his girl on the dance floor every time. But next up is Summer Walker, who got her fans out in the middle of NYC trying to break a glass to get her new album titled Still Over It. Take a look. Okay, so would you take a swing? I don't know. Maybe I'm different. It's not that serious to me. I don't understand how someone can become so obsessed or fan out over a human. Okay, somebody who's just like you. I've never been a minion, I guess. I don't know. Like, it's not that serious to me, but for others, it's exciting. Do y'all see it? They was going in with the little hammer, okay? But look, y'all make sure y'all subscribe to my channel. Comment down below and come on back for more, y'all. And I'm out of here. Bye.